मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल बेटा, एंड यू मस्ट बी डूइंग योर स्टडीज ऑल्सो. सो वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर 5. इन चैप्टर 5 वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन 3 पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस. सो टुडे वी विल डू चैप्टर 5 पार्ट 4. नाउ वॉट इज चैप्टर 5? इट्स मोर ऑन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल. सो वी आर हैविंग अ क्विक रीकैप ऑफ ऑल दोज 3 पार्ट्स दैट वी डिड बाय नाउ. Okay, so first we will have a recap, then I'll come on the today's topic. So what we have done by now, first we did introduction, like what is MS Excel. MS Excel is a spreadsheet software, how we can write formulas in, like text formulas are generally used to, we use concatenation in that, like Microsoft plus Excel, Microsoft Excel. Then we did numeric formulas which works on numbers. Then we did operators, arithmetic operators. These are arithmetic operators, plus, minus, multiplication, division, percentage and power, exponent. Okay, so these arithmetic operators we did. We did then relational operators and logical operators. Relational operators are used to compare two values. They form relational expressions. These operators always give a single value as result, true or false. And logical operators, they are used to compare two or more relational expressions. These operators also give a single value as a result, and this result could be either true or false. Then we did sorting of data. Sorting means we can arrange our data either in descending order or in ascending order. Descending means from small to big. Descending means from big to small. Ascending means from small to big, as you do in maths also. So in that way we can arrange data using Excel. Then operations on cells we did in the previous class. Overwriting cell contents, like something you have written, now you want to change it, so you can overwrite that cell content. Then modifying cell contents partially. Partially means half part is correct, half was wrong, so we change that partially. With which key we use to make changes partially? F2. Okay, then deleting cell contents, we deleted cell contents. Copy and paste, what were the shortcut keys for copy and paste? Ctrl+C and Ctrl+V. Then we did cut and paste, what were the shortcut keys for that? Ctrl+X and Ctrl+V. Now we are moving ahead on the today's topic, which is inserting row and columns. Then we will do deleting cells, then we will do inserting cells, then deleting deleting row and columns, it has been repeated. It's okay, it's inserting, it's deleting, so it's different. Okay, first then adjust row height, column width, and then last we will do autofill series. So let's start with inserting row and columns. Okay, so for that we have to open our Excel file. I'll try to open the previous Excel file only in which we worked. I'll show you over there. Okay, so how to open MS Excel, that we know now. How to open MS Excel, we click on this start button, and through that we can open the start button, and through that we can open MS Excel. Now we were working on an Excel file. If I have saved it, I'll try to figure it out. If it is not there, then we have to make one more. We will make changes in this only. I have opened this one file in Excel. Okay, now in this we will do that modifications that I told you we are going to do today. First was deleting cells. First was inserting cells. How we can insert cells? Now what is a cell? First of all, this, see, as soon as I do click, a rectangular selection is coming. It's coming. So this is selected cell. What is this? This is selected cell. So if we want to insert a cell, then how we will do that? We have to go to the home tab. After home tab, we have to go to on the insert. Okay, then insert tab, where we will go, we will click on insert option. Here in insert, we are finding the insert. We will click on the insert option to insert a cell. It's here in home tab, you can see it on the ribbon. Insert is there. Now we will click on this drop down arrow. Here we can see this insert cells. We will click on it. Now it will ask us whether we want cells down, we want cells on right side, or we want entire row. Suppose I want cells right side. Okay, so I will click on this and I'll do okay. So on the right side of that, a cell has been inserted. Did you see it? I'll do this again. I'm doing Control Z to explain it again. First, suppose we want a cell to be inserted here. Then I'll go on home tab. On the home tab, I'll go here in insert. In insert, I'll go on insert cells. Okay. Insert cells, as soon as I will click, it will give us options like whether I want entire row, I want to shift cells right, shift cells down. Previously I did cell right, now I am selecting a different option. Suppose I select on entire row, okay, and I did okay. See what happened. Our entire row has been inserted. Okay, so this way we can insert cell as well as rows. Okay, now we are moving ahead. After inserting cells, what was there? Inserting rows and columns. So row we have just inserted, we will see how to insert a column. Now suppose we want to insert a column here between this name and maths, so let's go to insert. Now insert column. As soon as I clicked, this column has come between name and maths. Again, I'll do it to show you. I was on maths. I went to insert option. I clicked on this small arrow, drop down arrow. As soon as I clicked on insert sheet column, the column is inserted. Okay. Again, I will show you for inserting sheet rows. I'll click here. This row has been inserted. Okay, so this way we can insert rows and columns. I hope you got it. Okay, now we are moving to the next topic, which was deleting cells. How to delete cells. See, on the ribbon you are having insert option and you are having delete option also. Okay, so if you will click on delete, you will get options which are related to delete. See here, if I will click on delete cells, the cell which is selected, which cell is selected, this cell is selected which is showing maths. So if I will click on this delete cells, and after deleting, where you want to shift the cells, left, up. So I have selected shift cells up. Okay, I'll do. See, that match has been deleted and cells has been shifted. See, now this place has been shifted, numbers has been shifted upward. Okay, let's do control Z, undo. I have done again. I'll show you what I did. Suppose this time I selected this name, I want to delete this. Where I'll go? I'll go and delete. I'll click on delete cells. So delete cells left if I select. Okay. See, on left side cells has been deleted. I'll do control Z. Okay, so this way we can delete the cells as well as we can delete rows also. Now how to delete rows? Suppose I want to delete this row, name, math, English. I have selected this name, then I'll go to delete option, delete sheet row. It is coming there. I'll click on this option. See, whole row has been deleted. I have pressed control Z to bring it back. Okay, now suppose if I want to delete this column, maths column, what will I do? Again I'll go to delete. I'll do delete sheet column. See, column is gone, even the title is also gone because it was there in that column. Again I did control to bring it back. Okay, so what we have learned: deleting rows, columns, before that deleting cells, inserting rows, columns and inserting cells, that we have learned by now. Now we will do adjusting row height and column width. Now to adjust the row height, where we will go? Suppose this is our row, this is 7 row I have selected. Okay, now we want to increase the height and later width of column. We want to increase the height of this row. Okay, so where we will go? We will go to format. In format, row height is coming, auto fit row height is coming. Now we will click on row height. Now there is some value which is coming. It's coming 23.25. okay, so if I will make it 33.25, let's see what happens. I'll click on OK. See, row height has changed. It has changed height. I'll bring it back to the previous one by pressing control Z. See, this was the height. Then what we made? We made it this. So this way we can change the height of row. And for changing height of row, where we went? We went to format. On the ribbon in home tab, here in home tab on the ribbon, we went to format option to change the row height. Now suppose I want to change the column width. This is my column, this column maths. Okay, now I want to change this column's width. See here, column width is there. I'll click on it. This column width value is coming 11.71. now I want to make it big. Suppose I am doing it 11 to 21. Okay, I wrote here 21.71. I did okay. See, as soon as I did, what happened? Column width has increased over here. Okay, I am doing it. See, it was 11.71 column width. When I changed it to 21.717, then it became this way. Just again I'll do it for this format, column width. Again it's 11.7. it was, we made it 21, okay, C. Okay, it was this much earlier, then we made it this much. So this way we can enhance the column width. Now the next topic is autofill series. What is autofill series? Autofill feature is used to enter predefined series of data. It could be text or it could be numbers in your list. For example, I'll show you here only how to create that autofill series. Suppose here I want to create numbers 1, then 2 I wrote. Okay. First I will select these two cells. I have selected. Now I will come to the right side. Now this small plus sign is coming. I'll just drag it. See, as I dragged it, what came? Numbers came automatically. 1 to 10 till the place I dragged that handle, these values came. So this is what? This is autofill series. Automatically it has filled this series with numbers. Similarly, we can do it on a difference also. Okay, suppose I wrote 2, then I wrote 4. Now I selected these two. I came to this side. This small plus sign has come. Okay, now I'll drag this. See, table of 2 has come. Okay, similarly we can do this for 5 difference also we can do. Okay, see here. This way you can get tables also easily, na? See. Okay, now this was with numbers. This autofill series was with numbers. We can work with text also. Text is like, suppose we are talking about Sunday, Monday. Sunday, then I wrote Monday. Okay. Then let's work on this. First we will select it. Then here, drag it, see, it has come Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, then again started it with Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So this way we can create a series using autofill feature. What is autofill feature or what is this series? It's a predefined series. We can create our own series or own list also, that we will do in the next session. This is all for today. Just do practice it and keep on doing your work. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you.